Hi. I've seen you over here working and working and working.
How you doing? I know, and I'm taking a little break right now.
I know. You look so productive over here. We love it.
Thank you.
Are you is that your van there?
Yeah, that's my van.
Are you working on it?
It's almost 100% done.
Wow, right on. Yeah, that would be awesome. What's your name?
My name is Giselle.
Giselle, do you have a YouTube channel?
I do not have a YouTube channel.
Okay, because they always ask. They always want to know. Okay.
Yeah, no, I don't.
Yeah, she's got all this going on here.
We have a Instagram.
Okay. What's that?
That would be under Giselle and Mark. It's J-I-S-E-L and Mark, M-A-R-K.
Right on.
The letter and.
Okay.
Or the words and.
Okay, yeah.
All right, so yeah, this is, we started this back in 2016 is when we bought it. And we started working on it like January, February 2017. We took it to Burning Man later on that year when it was about 60% done. And we came back and we did more work to it. And so it's almost finished.
Right on. But,
This was a straight cargo van. We installed the two windows and the third window here on the door.
Right on.
And we built everything from scratch. So we got all the insulation up, everything in there. We have our kitchen area here, of course.
Right.
With our filter water that runs really nicely. And this is all our drawers here. We have our propane tank in here. A little hammer.
Wow. Oh, that's so cute.
Yeah,
that's
adorable?
Their handle right there. That is cute.
Yeah, because he's more metal and I'm wood. So I did all the wood. We actually framed these out of metal. He framed them out of metal and then we put plywood sides and faces so that I can do the drawers and build the drawers out so we can have everything in here.
Right on.
Hinges. So this is basically just all our kitchen area, our supplies for kitchen, and
you've got some major storage going
on
there.
Yeah, it works out so great. So we have 320 watts of solar power up above, and a bank of four batteries down here,
and right underneath the couch area.
The couch is actually the bed, so this actually slides out.
Oh, right on.
And that comes down. And we designed it so these two are the exact same size so we can flip them around in case it starts to get worn in one section.
Right.
And so that comes out to about here so we can still walk back and forth. I designed this little desk. This is my favorite.
I love that desk. That's so cool.
My favorite part of my little build here is my little desk. So I can pull that out, get this out here, and I can actually do some work.
Yeah.
You know, designing or whatever I need to do. And then this little desk actually works as a dinette. So I sit there, he sits here, and we eat. And then at night, it works as a nightstand. So it's actually a multi-purpose little desk. And it's designed so I can, it's one little single unit, a few screws to hold it in place. I can remove it if I need to do more just carpentry work. And I want to have my toolbox permanently here, then I can do that too.
Yeah, because you've been doing a lot of work out here. So have you always done like...
I'm a carpenter, been doing it for 30 years.
Yeah, I could kind of tell.
I was 18 when I got into the trades.
Okay.
Joined the Carpenters Union, worked for Alley Unified as a maintenance carpenter for 18 years.
Okay.
Quit them about 4 years ago. Yeah.
Yeah, I knew you knew what you were doing.
I
was raised with a carpenter. Yeah. My father has always been into custom homes and
yeah,
so
these are
building
all my tools.
Right.
Well, not all. Mark's got some.
So, right.
Yeah, we actually I went really low budget on this.
Well, that's okay.
But it works for me.
Yeah.
I want to be able to, you know, to see everything out here and at night with this is closed. It just looks really homey.
Right.
And we live in an artist community, so I have a lot of artist friends and I still have more. They're all up here. This is all my artsy-fartsy stuff that I can play with. And I want to fill this up with all my friends.
Oh, yeah.
So when I say 90% done, this needs to get doors like this.
Okay.
So with little switch, you know, just... We have all the hardware and everything. We've just been kind of slacking on doing it.
Well, I think you've done a beautiful job.
And
amazing.
Ta-da! We have a shower.
Okay. Oh!
A shower.
I was thinking that was a lot longer than it was, but I see now.
This is,
okay.
This is our shower pan here. This curtain goes here. This curtain will go around the track all the way around. Cover this up. So this is just wood also. And we painted it because if it gets nicks like this, we were trying to get some art in here. And Nick, that we can just fix that and paint it. instead of having like a laminate or anything. And then if I change my mind and want to go pink or blue or, you know, yellow, then I can do it.
Right.
So yeah, we have an on-demand hot water heater over here for the shower.
Okay.
And 20 gallons fresh water, 20 gallons gray water down below. This is a composting toilet. We have a generator that normally is inside of here. It's outside right now, so we can use it. This is where all the bedding goes, so the pillows and all the big blankets for our bed. And up here's all our towels and our toiletries, you know, my blow dryer and everything else in there.
Right.
So yeah, when we did this, we did. We have everything set up for the computers, and you can plug everything else in here.
Okay. And then you have almost a full fridge.
Yeah.
Huh?
This fridge is amazing.
Right.
I love this fridge, and it runs 24/7. Everything's in little baskets. So
yep.
That it
I love those little
around.
Baskets. I have baskets that have little mm-hmm. handles on them, and I love them.
Yeah. I mean,
for organizing
and putting everything in.
Right.
We have
convection.
Convection microwave, which we hardly ever use.
Yeah, we took our microwave out.
Most people do.
Yeah, we just, I don't know, we took it out the very first month we lived in it and in Freedom, our other camper, because we were just like, man, we never use it, you know?
No, so. My thing is, if I was, the only thing I would change is I would get the refrigerator with the freezer.
Yeah, you know? Okay.
But I'm happy with this.
Right,
so we're not living in it full time yet. So right now the longest we've gone out is 2 months. Summer trip, we did a whole 2 months. And then when we did Burning Man, that was 5 weeks. So
that's fun.
Oh, yeah, fun.
My
except
sister
for the
went,
cleanup
but,
afterwards.
Right.
I mean, we had dust everywhere.
My sister went 2 years in a row, so I know, yeah.
Yeah, that trip, we didn't even have handles on this. And
right.
I was like doing this.
Right.
Nothing was painted. This was made out of particle board. And yeah, so basically just getting the doors on here is what we need to do, and maybe a little section here.
But you've secured these now with just, how are these secured?
This is bungee.
Okay.
This is some stuff left over that I had from a job, earthquake tie downs.
Okay.
Tying down different things. So this, I can actually set the size of this to whatever I want. But if anybody does anything like that, you can do a little eye hook and just do your little bungees.
Okay.
You know,
right.
You can buy the little bag of bungees, and then that keeps this from going anywhere.
Okay.
And I love this system because you can just...
Yeah, you don't have to take it off. You just pull it down, and then there you go. You got your...
Go through my stuff.
Yep. Put it right back up in there.
It goes right back up in here.
Yeah, that's great.
It works just fine.
Awesome.
So, and then when we have the doors, we'll probably get rid of this because the doors with this hardware, it actually holds it in place.
Right, right.
I don't drive like a maniac anyway.
Right on.
I'm the driver.
Well, yeah, this is amazing. I love it.
We have an AC. We have a heater. It's down below, and this heats us up in the... Here's our...
Okay,
warm.
Yeah.
These are our bedroom lights. Everything's on dimmer switches. I wanted all the little clicky buttons, so Mark gave me all the little clicky buttons because I just like the way they feel.
Yeah,
and
you
so,
know that when you're turning them on, they're turning on. I get you.
You know, I'm just one of those little weird.
No, I kind of get it that way.
And then we also have a vacuum, which I think is amazing.
Yeah. Okay.
It's actually underneath here. It's on the side here.
It's like plugged into, it's built in like what you would have like at the house.
Mm-hmm. Wow. I got a 30-foot hose in that drawer. I just plug this thing in here, and then all the dust that you see right now will get vacuumed out of here. But not right away, because it's going to happen every day. So yeah, here's the drawer with our stuff.
Wow, okay, that's the first time I've seen that in a van.
Oh, the vacuum is great. Before I had that screen on, we actually were in Lake... Havasu.
Okay.
Telephone Cove.
Yeah. Okay.
So we were there, and within 20 minutes, we had hundreds of them all over. So I was like, okay, what are we gonna do? So I started with the fly swatter.
Yeah.
And I'm like, that's not gonna work. And then I started, and then I was like, oh, a lighter. Oh, no, that's not gonna work. And I was like, oh wait, I have a vacuum. So then we put this up. And I vacuumed everything up and everything.
Yeah, we had the same thing going on.
Except this is a cute little story. Not cute, but so I vacuumed everything up and I was excited. This thing was on. All the bugs were caught in here. That goes off at night when the temperature drops. My head
was right there.
Right here.
Oh, so you got...
It fell on. It was like all, a silhouette on a pillow.
And he woke up. I'm glad I didn't wake up before. And he woke up and he was trying to clean them all off.
Oh, my gosh. Do you want to introduce, is this your partner, a husband?
This is Mark.
Hi, Mark.
My husband, my partner.
Hi.
We camped with them one night.
We camp together?
This is Destination Open Road.
Yeah.
We camped with you at the Blue Hair and Cheese Factory the last time you were there.
Oh! You were running around with a tablet or something, writing stuff down or something.
I don't think that was us.
No.
You guys came in and everybody was kind of tired.
You guys said,
yeah.
I don't know that. Did we talk to her?
We didn't talk to anybody.
No, because I think I went in. I went into the camp. I was tired.
Yeah, everybody you were there and this lady over here
Wandering
was there.
Jimmy.
Yes. Well, I'm glad we finally met.
Yeah, well, thank you.
She was out here doing something and I just kind of came over with the camera. And she asked me if I wanted to come in. I was so excited.
Show off my little rig or our rig.
Well, it's beautiful. Do you guys plan on going full time at any time soon?
Not anytime soon. Yeah. We're still just kind of.
We go as long as we can, but we like to come home.
Yeah, we love where we live.
Yeah.
You know, in the artist community, and we still have to work.
Right.
So I still got to go back where all my tools, you know. Eventually, maybe we'll get a trailer and actually load it up and have and tow that around and then do, you know, carpentry and building work and wherever we land.
That composting toilet.
Yes.
You're not on the road you're not on the road every month.
No.
Do you think if you were full timing, do you think that would be sufficient?
That's the best
sufficient?
Way to go. Yeah, we had a porta potty.
Okay.
And that one, within 3 days, we have to clean it out. And you have to find a place, a toilet or somewhere to dump it out. When you're out in the desert for 2 weeks, this will work. 3 weeks is what we went without any issues or nothing.
Okay.
And then you just put that in a trash bag. And it smells like soil. You don't smell anything foul. The urine is the only thing that you do every day, you know, to dump that. But
I was real leery about it. The idea of it didn't appeal to me. And then all of a sudden we said, we got to get one. And we got one. And I wouldn't go back. It's really the best way to go.
Yeah, I've heard some people say that it doesn't break down as fast. But that just might be the toilets that they have. And they're not doing it correctly.
If you're in a very wet area, like we were along the coast a lot, it was really foggy and stuff, then it doesn't dry out as fast.
Right.
And then maybe you'll get some issues. But we didn't have too bad of an issue.
We didn't. You know?
So that might just be the thing that you need to check into. Is if you're in a different climate area.
Yeah, if it's too moist.
It's on a fan.
It's got a little fan that keeps it dry.
Right.
You know, but we had, for two people, 3 weeks is plenty long.
Right. I mean,
we don't have to worry about water for it. We don't have to worry about, you know, any of that stuff.
Right. Because that seems to be the number one thing, like shower and toilet. Like, how do you do that?
A lot of people don't have those. And that's
right.
I'm always like, no, we're going to build it. You know,
she took a hot shower this morning.
Right.
Yeah, I took a nice hot shower.
Trying to start the day.
Right.
You know, after all the dust.
I can go days.
We did that too this morning. I was like, I've had enough dust. I'm taking a shower. But now we have to go dump because we're gray and all of that. And then we use our toilet, so we've got to find a dump. You know, we'll have to go back through Parker, 8 miles back, and dump. So.
Yeah, so our gray water. We have to dump that too.
Right.
Gray water can dump pretty much anywhere.
Right.
When we take it home. We'll put it in a bucket.
Sure.
My gray water's a macerator, so I just plug a hose in, a garden hose disconnect, push a button, and it just shoots 30 feet, just take it right out.
Right. That works great.
And it works out wonderful for us.
Right.
I mean, I didn't want a black tank. I didn't want to have to deal with that. I didn't want to have to deal with even working with the hose.
That was the one thing when we moved into the camper, though, we were like...
down in Parker, I think.
Hamburger.
He's asking for, what was he doing? Asking for a hamburger?
We're serving food here.
Every day he's come by, he's like, is the food ready yet?
We'll
give him the idea that this was a lunch truck.
How funny. Maybe he needs to bring you guys lunch.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, so... Do you ever have people come in here and want you guys to build out for them?
When we go places, we've had people offer to buy this one from us. And we're like, no, this is our baby.
Yeah.
But we have one guy who said he was going to keep bugging us until we build one for him. Because we're like,
I would think you guys could make a killing off of designing and building.
I think it would kill me.
It could.
And there's a lot of liability issues. My daughter's company, San Diego Camper Vans, they're building
San Diego
building
Camper
them now.
Vans, they're doing that now.
And they're having, you know, there's issues with putting stoves in and things, putting propane inside. There's a lot of things that you're just not supposed to do.
Right. For a van. or
any RV, a propane tank inside. Technically, you're not supposed to do that.
Oh, that's right, because ours is outside.
It's still just as dangerous. Yeah. It's not dangerous. Propane's safe.
Yeah, I mean, so yeah, there's a lot of the liabilities and stuff like that.
Right.
But I would be more than happy to assist anybody with at least designing it.
We'd rather come here and volunteer.
Volunteer, help people build their stuff, give them ideas. You know, we're both builders, and so we know how to attach things, make things.
Right.
And, you know, and just the design of it. And so that's probably my favorite part is just, we took about 3 months, I think, to design it. We came out here, we would sit out here, we had tape on the floor.
That's the fun part, yeah.
I cut out cardboard boxes so I can see where I wanted this, you know, because I didn't want
to get it. It'd be so easy to go with an existing design and just copy it, but... Mm-hmm. She came up with a design, and I hadn't seen really anything like it. Now I have. Now we actually see. Did they see a picture of our van or something?
Yeah,
that somebody's coming.
Yeah, well, I mean, I've seen like the couch and maybe the kitchen setup, kind of, but the shower blew me away. I did not expect you to show me that shower back there.
It's no accident that you feel like you have space in here.
Yeah,
because it's
huge.
Of an inch,
and
a quarter of an inch.
I mean, you have more room in here than I've got in my camper. And I've got a lot of room in there, but this is beautifully set up.
Isn't it feel comfortable?
Yeah.
I love being able to sit here and see where you're sitting.
I know, this is so comfortable. Yeah.
We were at one van life meetup, and the guy next to us had bought one that was already pre-made. And she sat down. She's like, I don't want to go back to his. And she literally sat and talked to
you know
for
who
like
he is,
2 hours.
Too, but
we're not going to say, but it was really cute.
That's like, Scott and I, when we got married, we lived on a boat. And this reminds me of sitting up in, you know, the captain's seat with somebody sitting in our living room area.
Yeah.
It's very comfy
this
cozy.
Too.
Yeah, it's very cozy.
Hardly
well,
ever
I don't.
Turn
yeah,
around.
I mean, you got a beautiful couch to sit on.
That's Mark's little captain seat, and that's my little seat.
I like that
there.
One.
That's my favorite.
The one lady said, "Do you have to make your bed every day?" We're like, "Oh wow." I mean, you have a sofa. There's no bed. You're not coming in here to a bedroom.
Yeah. Well, I close my curtain on my bedroom, but we make our bed every day
it
too.
Take long to make this
no.
Bed. Oh no, not at all. And the thing is, I like being able. It looks more like a little office, more like a living room.
Right.
You know, I don't want the bed, because I know self. There'll be days if I'm just in bed, if I had a bed, I may just want to stay in bed all day.
Right.
You know, and I don't want to stay in bed all day. I took an Atlas apart and did a little
decoupage.
So we got little pins in there.
Right.
Where we've been, where we're going. So this is all here. And since we're from California, I got the big California
right
here. And then this is the loop that we did this summer.
That's really cool. I want to do something like that too.
And this is all the places that we've been. When I built this, I still have more to do. I'm just going to keep adding to it.
That's really neat.
And just keep adding to it.
The art wall, you said the art wall.
Yep, she's going
to
paint.
We have some art we have to hang that
all
when we
right.
We got some art that, you know, from our...
And of course,
right.
The knickknacks that you have to get everywhere.
Oh, yeah.
That's what I'm trying to do is figure out how I want to make mine a little bit more homey, you know.
More personal.
Yeah, I mean, I don't have a lot of wall space, so it's kind of...
This is why
kinda,
I did this.
Yeah.
Because the windows took care of, you know, took all the space.
Right.
I'm like, I need to have something, so... I did the balance.
Yeah. I think
like,
when you're full time,
well,
no, I think it's beautiful. I think when you're full time or even just if you're doing a couple months, mm-hmm. you got to have that homey feeling, you know? My neighbor before we left gave me a plant and I love it. It's the only plant I've had in the camper, you know?
Yeah.
But we had freedom and I had stuff all over the walls. And this one, I just haven't been able to figure out exactly what I want to do.
Right?
Last night, come on in, Jamie.
I thought you were filming.
I am. You want to say hello to everybody?
Make a message. I have us a brand new unused cassette toilet for the van and a cooktop.
Nice. Perfect.
Cool. Really?
Awesome.
So they're just going to come and put them at the back.
Okay.
Oh, that's amazing. Absolutely. Thank you.
Yep. Is that for a van? For you guys? Or?
No. I'm not going to give away the thing, but
okay.
It's a thing. We're working
it's a thing.
On
it's a thing.
We'll
thing. Yeah, you'll go to Jamie's channel.
Off camera will tell it to you.
Okay, very cool.
Because we don't know if that's something that's
okay.
Going on
right now. I'm going to get out of your guys' way. I got to go over and edit, but thank you. And
thank you.
Give your daughter a plug one more time.
Lacey and Brian, San Diego Camper Vans.
Okay.
They're also the ladies' van on Instagram.
So go on over there, and your guys' Instagram is?
Just Jisel and Mark, J-I-S-E-L-A-N-D, Mark, M-A-R-K.
All right.
So, yeah.
Thank you guys for letting us come into your home. We appreciate it. Thank you.
All right, anytime. Bye.